Hello, students. Let's read the problem. And it says, Jessica bought a new car for $23,000. The car depreciates 10% per year. Which of the following exponential graphs represents P, the value of the car after 2 years? Okay, so what are they asking me to do? Well, they want to find out which one of the graphs, which are my exponential graph, will represent the value of the car after so many years. Is that right? So what do I know about Jessica? Well, we know that she bought a new car and she paid $23,000, right? Okay. And then it says that the car depreciates 10% per year. So the first thing I'm going to ask you is, do we know what is depreciates, right? Well, think about depreciates are something that goes down, okay? So depreciates means that the price of the car will start going down or lower and lower every year. Is that right? That's what depreciate means, okay? It means that even though Jessica paid $23,000 for the car, if she wants to sell it after, I don't know, 5 years, she will not be able to sell it for $23,000 because the car depreciated 10% per year. Okay, so that's the reason why we think about down, because the price, or the, in this case, the value of the car, okay, will go down. Okay, very good. So what about if we write down an exponential function for this? Okay, so we're going to start with this. Let's see if this looks familiar for you guys, right? What does that 8 represent? 8 represents a starting value. Right? What is the starting value of the car? Well, it's $23,000. Right? What about B? What does the B represent? B, it's the change that is happening in the problem, right? How fast something is changing. And of course, that has to do with the price of the car. And it says that it depreciates 10%. So that means we said that it means that it was going down. Is that right? It goes down by 10% each year. So what we're going to do is, that means that if the price of the car was 100% and it depreciates 10%, we are going to subtract 10% from there, and that will give me 90%. Is that right? So 90%, it's the number that goes in here, but not as a percent, as a decimal. Okay? And this will be the T because it's the number of years, okay? So remember that my 90%, I got to change that to a decimal. And that's the number that goes in the parentheses, okay? So we said a few minutes ago that A is the starting value of the car. Is that right? So what about if we go to the answer choices? And what's the starting point for any of all of my answer choices? Well, in A, my starting point is kind of close to 2,250. That's not even close to what we want, right? So that cannot be my answer. What about C? What is the starting point for that one? It's less than 1,250. So can that be my answer? No, right? So we're looking for a starting point of 23,000 or close to that, okay? So let's go to the next. How about B? Well, B looks like somewhere a little bit higher than 22,500. It could be. And letter D is also a little bit higher than 22,500. So those two can be my answers, right? Could be one of my answers. So the question is, how do I determine which one is actually my answer? So this is what I'm going to ask you to do. What we're going to do is we're going to work at this problem. Okay. But now I am going to replace T with a specific number of years. So I can replace that with a 1, with a 2, a 3, and this will be the time in years, right? So I'm going to go ahead and choose a 2. So what does that mean? It means that once I work it out, when X is 2, right, which is the T for times, I'm looking for the value of the car after 2 years, okay? So if we work it out, we're going to get 23,000, right? And 0.90 times 0.90 gives me 9 times 9 is 81, right? Well, it gives me 0.81. Okay? And if you multiply, so go ahead and multiply that. Multiply 23,000 times 0.81, and we get Y equals 18,630. So that's the price of the car, more or less, after 2 years. So I'm going to write it down here. Okay? So remember, this is the years, right? And this is the value of the car after that many years. Okay? So right now, I am going to look for that order pair. Okay? So I'm looking for 2. So I'm going to just check on B and D, right? So this is 2. And I'm looking for around 18,000. Okay? So that would be somewhere around here. And this would be 2. Is that point on the curve or on my exponential graph? No, it's not, right? So that means B cannot be my answer. So let's check D. So I'm at 2, and we're going to go up, remember. And once I go all the way up, I'm going to stop here, and I'm going to look this way. Right? Is that right? So that's exactly what we could have done for letter B. Look, you go all the way up on 2, but look, that 2 would be way up there if I wanted to look for that 18,000. That is stopped somewhere over here, which is very small number, right? So can letter D works? It does, right? Because it's a little bit higher than 17,500. So it looks to me that that should be the answer. Very good, okay? So remember, if you're trying to match a problem, first you go and write down the equation for that or the function. You replace the starting value, which is A, and then you go on to B. Now, remember that this is a decay. So I'm going to write it down over here. And remember, decay is when B is less than 1, but greater than 0, of course, right? So in this case, B, it is less than 1, because look at my value for B. B is 0.90, and that it is less than 1, okay? So this is the way that we can match our graph.